Do you have a favorite stock you like to track in Excel? Maybe something like a video game reseller? Or maybe two favorite stocks you want to hold on to, like this movie theater chain? If you want to learn how to use and customize this workbook, then grab your favorite latte or tea and let's get started. Thanks for watching. As usual, you can go to the link in the description and download this workbook and all the source code. This workbook has a customizable list of stocks with some information, so let's walk through some of the features here. As you select each row, you can see a highlight appears to help you identify the related data in each row. This is done through conditional formatting that I'll show you later. Each row has a little dot 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 to the left of it. Just clicking on that or putting the selection in there will pop open a form for that row that has a year chart plus a little more information. You can open multiple of these and they'll float above the grid as you change sheets, or they can float outside of the Excel window as well, just given that they're a form. Clicking anywhere in them will drag them around, and if you right-click them, that'll close them. It's a quick and easy way to just pop out some information to compare between stocks. There's a search at the top which searches the list, so you can just type in a ticker and you'll get the ticker back. Or if you type in part of the company name, like if we wanted to see everything that had a corp, and that'll filter the list by the name. There's a spark line that represents the closing price trend. The number at the top represents the days, and so if you change that number, it'll change the number of days the spark line represents. And there's a daily low and high, and then a 52-week low to high. You can see the bar in between them representing where the price is relative to the low and high. At the time of recording this, there happens to be a lot of stocks near their 52-week low. If you switch sheets, you can see the list of stocks that it's pulling from. And this is effectively the list of stocks you're tracking. So you can customize this list in certain delete rows. And if you want to add a new stock, you just type in the name of the company or the ticker. You'll see that the stock data type appears. You can click the icon to look at some of the information on it. If you want to remove it, you just right-click on the row header and hit delete. To refresh all the data, you can use the refresh button on the data tab or on the right-click. Or if you go to refresh settings on data types, you'll see a pane open up and there'll be a refresh all you can do, and you can set an interval of how often it refreshes, or on file open or manually. Sometimes when you hit refresh, you'll see an error that says it couldn't refresh all of them. To help address this, on the source list of stocks, there's a days since last refresh, so you can quickly see which ones haven't been refreshed. You'll also see a little green triangle on it, and from there you can either find a new way to get the data or just hit delete on that stock as it's not tracked anymore through the stock data type. So let's start breaking down the workbook a little bit to see how it's made. I'll turn on the headers here, and you'll see that for the low and high bars, they're really just cells that are squished in. You can see each row also has a history tied to it that builds the spark line. And as I change 30 to 60, you can see that that updates the 60 over in the stock history, and that changes the stock history formula to go get that many. And if I change it to 5, you can see it adjusts it to 5 as well. I personally like to leave it at 30, so I'll just adjust that back real quick. And if I unhide the columns to the left, you can see this is where the data type array comes in and how the highlighting's done. So as you select each row, the VBA catches the event and then puts a 1 in the highlight. There's a conditional format that will light that row up a different color. The hidden data type array is brought in through the filter function, and that allows us to hook up the search box to it so that when the search box has something in it, the filter can apply and filter down to the data types that contain ticker equal to that or its name equal to that. You can search for both by adding the two searches together, which works like an OR. For the high to lows, the bar is just a cell shrunk down. You can select each one, and then you set the value of each one of those and have a CF on top of it. So in this case, you can see for the top row that 204 is the value of each bar between the low and high for the year. Let's look at the forms now. When you click the dot, 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 they appear. What happens on another sheet is that the data type gets set there, and then a stock history is created for the year, and then there's a chart that builds that out, and then we grab the low and the high for the year. And we need to know the low and high so that we set the correct min and max for the axes of the chart and put all of that into the form. And the form looks a little cut off. That's because we're going to hide the title bar, and that'll get us some room back. The way we hide the title bar is just through a simple function that calls a bunch of APIs. It looks a little complicated, but it's not that bad. It's really just a bunch of dealing with 32-bit versus 64-bit stuff. This is the update function that updates the form with the information. The way we get the chart into the form is by having the chart save itself out as an image and then loading that into the form. And with that, we're done. Let me know if there's anything else you'd like explained. Have a great day.